and welcome to New Orleans Cooking with the Fields family. If you're interested in learning how to make some New Orleans seafood gumbo, keep watching. Danielle Deoundra, this is my grandmother.
Hi, happy holidays.
And my mom.
Hi, happy holidays.
And today we're going to show you our family's
three-generational gumbo recipe.
This gumbo recipe has been passed down from my great-grandmother Florence to my grandmother Sandra, and now to me and my mom. So we hope you all enjoy this video. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned to learn how to cook our gumbo. Our ingredients are chopped garlic, parsley, hot sausage balls, sausage, okra, and whole peeled tomatoes. Also, last but not least, our Gendry's fresh seasoning. So we're starting off this gumbo with number one, our first pot, which is our turkey necks, which are boiling. Then we have our seafood pot. This is the remainder of the seafood that we have boiled. And we're going to mix these two pots together and also create the roux.
Okay, now we're going to make the roux. We add about a cup and a half of cooking oil to our skillet. And then we add our flour. You have to stir it real fast because it's going to go real fast. It's going to be a bit lumpy, but that's okay. Stir it up. Keep it moving. Add a little more because as you can see, that's not enough. And we're going to keep cooking this until it's about the color of chocolate, a dark chocolate. We're going to add this to our turkey pot that's going too fast. Just a little. See how fast it goes?
Mm-hmm.
And you can't let this burn. If you do, it's going to ruin you. It's going to turn your food to a bitter taste. Don't touch it because it's really hot. I may want to stop with the water. And when you add the water to it, you got to be very careful. Yeah, it's the color of chocolate. Mm-hmm. So now we're going to add some of our seasoning to it. Put some in there. I'm gonna stop. This is going to cool it down. This is what creates the roux. Oh, now we're just about ready. Okay, get the pot boiling here.
The other way. There you go.
That's the turkey pot. You see, we have our seasoning, our roux. We're going to add the roux to the turkey. You see, it continues to get brown. It's a nice chocolatey brown right now. Okay, now the roux is ready to go to the gumbo pot. The pot we're going to use to make the gumbo. As you can see, it's nice and dark, and it has the seasoning in it. Everything involved in the roux has to be done real fast. Come around here and get it.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to stir this pot real good. Stir it real fast. Alright. We're going to let that cook until the roux is all dissolved. Alright. Now we're ready for our seafood pot. Seafood boil from all the crabs mm-hmm. and the shrimp. Go pour it in there. You know, all of it. And pour a little more. That's good. Alright. Now we're ready for our tomatoes.
Oh, not yet.
Now, we're going to let this cook until it gets thick. Not real thick. But you see, it's thickening up now. We're going to let it cook down a little bit, and then we're going to add our ingredients. So right now, it's just a matter of letting it cook maybe for about 20 minutes.
Our gumbo has been boiling for about 10 minutes and it's getting thick. We'll be back when we are ready to add the seafood. And occasionally stir the gumbo as you're letting it thicken.
And the white part is the fat. It's coming off of your turkey. And sometimes you might want to skim that off when you get to the end of your gumbo.
It's been 20 minutes and now we're adding the crabs into the gumbo. We're gonna let this cook together.
Mm-hmm. Fresh crabs.
Our fresh crabs.
Okay, as you can see, our gumbo has cooked down. It has, the consistency of it has changed. It's getting a little thick. So now we're gonna add the rest of our ingredients. First thing is gonna be the smoked sausage. Smoked sausage has been in the microwave, kind of get a little flavor to them. The next thing we're going to add is we have a little hot sausage. Hot sausage balls that were also put in the microwave. Okay, we'll stir this a bit. Then we'll add our okra. The okra went in the microwave too to get some of the slime off. We're gonna turn the fire up a little bit and let this cook a bit, and then we're gonna add our garlic and our parsley. Now we'll add our 7 cloves of garlic. We have all our ingredients in that we're gonna use. And we're gonna turn the fire up and let it cook down some more.
So we're picking up the spoon to see the consistency of the gumbo. The consistency is based on what you would like, but we feel like this is just about thick enough for us. So we're gonna go ahead and add our shrimp. As you know, shrimp doesn't take that long, so it'll be about 5 minutes or less, and then we'll add the parsley at the end. Our final ingredient is the parsley. And we're going to lower the fire and let this simmer, and then we'll add our seasonings afterwards. The gumbo has been simmering and now we're skimming the grease off of the top. Here are pictures of our New Orleans okra seafood gumbo. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for supporting us here on Cooking with the Fails Family. And thank you to my grandmother, Sandra, for helping us with this recipe. See you in our next upload.